So you want to improve memory and concentration. That's a little greedy, don't you think? No, it's not. They actually go together because part of your ability to concentrate is going to have something to do with the robustness of your working memory, for example, and many, many other levels of memory. Now, are there any quick tips, tricks, and hacks and so forth? There might be. There might be other people willing to flog them. I'm not necessarily interested in those kinds of things. What I'm interested in is the foundations, the fundamentals, what's going to last the long term. And if you would like that kind of information and be able to have long-term memory gains, then you're going to want to improve memory and concentration from the ground up, rather than constantly playing a game of snakes and ladders where you're up one day, down the next. And that's what we're going to talk about today. This is Dr. Anthony Metivier from MagneticMerryMethod.com. Hit that thumbs up if you like this kind of content. Get subscribed if you're new here, because we are going deep into preserving the mind. No matter how old you are or how young you are, this is the game, especially in the world of information overwhelm. Okay, so one of the problems here is there's a chicken and the egg. Where do you start? Concentration or memory? I would suggest if you're really, really, really starved for concentration, get yourself a deck of cards and lay those cards out on the floor and do so in such a way that you play what is sometimes called dueling back. You turn over a six of hearts and then you turn it back over and then you keep turning over cards. And when you find the six of diamonds, you try to remember where was the six of hearts and you play a game of pairs that way. This is going to give you something to concentrate on while exercising your memory. You can get a similar effect by building puzzles and, oh, I saw a piece that may be useful and where did I put that piece? But I think this is just a little bit more interesting and fun, and there's more you can do with playing cards. So why not have them ready to go? Now, the natural question is, well, can't I use an app? Can't I do this on my phone? Oh, yes, you can. But would you? Why would you do anything on the phone that is the great machine designed to ruin your concentration and your focus by bling, bling, bling ads or constantly tempting you to go and pull up this window instead of focusing on that window? Don't throw the technology out. I'm not saying that. But there is a thing called digital dementia, digital amnesia, and these things are real, and people are suffering. So try to spend as much time as you can away from the screens. I've been spending a lot of time with cards lately, and I've been playing a variety of games like this in order to just preserve my own concentration and focus, because these days we all have to be online. But that is not the greatest thing if you want to have your memory preserved. Some people may argue about this. There are people who have told me all kinds of things about dueling back online and so forth. I asked them, would you please come on the podcast and I'll give you some stuff to memorize and you can demonstrate your tremendous gains from your digital playing around with these things. They never deliver. And I don't believe they can, because if they could, they would. But it's just not going to happen. It can't really happen because you want to preserve your information for the real world, not digital environments. So use real things. There is one exception, though, and that is that some memory competitors do train solely online. But notice that they're memory competitors. And if you want to be a memory competitor, by all means, listen to the memory competitors. I'm such a person that I want to remember what I read. I want to learn languages and be able to recall what, at least basically, what I've done. Pronunciation, I have to work on extra hard, but being able to remember how the words basically sound and how to use them in sentences, that's something that comes from focus and concentration. And that's my next suggestion for you. If you're not already doing something with language, do anything with language. Either improve your mother tongue by regularly memorizing words that you don't know, or study another language. Now, when I say study another language, you don't have to go all the way in for full fluency. You can get massive benefits by just memorizing some quotes in Latin. Omnium expedendorum prima esse sapientia in qua perfecti boni forma consistit. Oh, it feels so good. But it also is exercising my focus and my concentration and my memory all at the same time. Because in order to memorize it, I have to concentrate on it. And I have to use memory techniques. The memory techniques I choose to use are the memory palace. It's the foundational technique. And by using it, you are increasing your focus and concentration. It's a perfect circle. I can't think of anything better. And if you need help with that, get my free course at magneticmemorymethod.com/YT. That's where I teach the memory palace technique in full with exercises. In fact, in the first 2 minutes of that course, there's an exercise so powerful that if you would just put it into action, follow my recommendation, you will get an memory improvement and concentration exercise in the first 2 minutes. And then you just follow the next one and the next one and the next one. Sometimes people email me and they say, well, you said this course was free. And I say, well, where's your homework assignment? Because if you listen to the first 2 minutes, you get the most powerful thing that I could ever hope to give you. So pay attention. Now, I know that some people can't pay attention because they're so looking for the dopamine spike and they no longer understand what value is. So here's another memory and concentration exercise. Repeat what people are saying so that you're actually paying attention to it. I've had to do this often in my life. My mind flies in so many directions at the same time that I can sit right in front of you and we can be talking and I'll just notice, oh, I haven't paid a single attention to anything you've said. Then I start to pay attention by repeating what you're saying to me. It sounds kind of crazy, but it works. It works incredibly to attune focus. And then if you have memory techniques, you can start using the person's body as a memory palace and you put keywords around them. So if somebody mentions the title of a book, I can put just that main keyword of the title on top of their head by using their body as a memory palace and using a visualization memory technique in order to be able to think back what was happening there above their head and recall that information. And it's a wonderful, wonderful way to improve concentration in the moment and memory and remember what was being said in the conversation. And sometimes it's just simple things. I was speaking with somebody the other day and he mentioned 30 years. Well, Mickey Mouse is one of the images that I use for 30. There's a specific technique that I teach and that I've used for years that helped me decide why Mickey Mouse would be the image for 30. And you can learn that on some of the videos that I've taught. It's based on the major method. If you learn the major and then you develop it to what's called a 00 to 99 PAO, you will have an image for every two-digit number from 00 to 99. Anyway, it's just a simple example. When someone said, oh, you know, I've been doing this for 30 years, bam, I have repeated in my head what they're saying, and then I can place Mickey Mouse somewhere on their body, on their shoulder, over their heads, etc. It's a very, very powerful thing to do. I know that these things can be difficult. They can be hard. Sometimes we need a bit of a community, we need some accountability, and we just need some ongoing inspiration. So soon I'll be opening my inner circle for new members, but you need to take the free course in order to even receive a notification about that. So if you're interested in preserving your mind, as I am interested in preserving my own mind, please go to magneticmerrymethod.com/YT and you will start to be notified when these wonderful things are open for you to get involved, if you would like to. Now, I said that cards can go deeper and deeper still. If you devote yourself in the way that I hope you will, because we want as many people to be as sharp and focused and concentrated with stellar memories as possible in the future, let's hope that we all invest. This is a wonderful way to improve your focus and concentration. And if you develop images for each and every number, well, every card is numbered. There's different ways to number them. There's a particular way that I number them. James Gerwing followed my approach. He won the 2019 Canadian Memory Championship by doing it the way that I do it. And that was a great honor that he would actually practice it in that way. In any case, if you have an image for every playing card, then you can practice memorizing the order of cards. And you can do a lot of fun stuff, including memory tricks, and I love to do what's called memdeck magic. It's very challenging, it's very difficult, but it helps improve your focus and your concentration. And really, all you have to do is have an image for each and every card, right? So memorizing cards is a wonderful focus and concentration exercise that allows you to memorize cards, and it is a little bit more robust than laying out, okay, so here's the four of diamonds, where's the four of hearts, here's the six of diamonds, where's the six of hearts, and, you know, flipping cards over. You get a much more robust exercise by memorizing the core cards in the order that they come out. And all you have to do is set up the system. Very, very powerful. If you're not interested in cards, well, then there's something a little bit more direct that will have value, which is something I also do, which is to use cards like this. And if you'd like to know more about that system for cards and how that I place cards in memory palaces based on what I'm studying, how I extract information from books, etc., watch How to Memorize a Textbook next.